Hello, welcome to another GoJS intermediate tutorial. This video will explain and demonstrate the Relinking Tool and Link Reshaping Tool GoJS comes equipped with. It will also demonstrate how one might wish to modify parts associated with tools. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. Additionally, this video assumes you understand the basics of GoJS, which are covered in the GoJS Beginner Videos series. It is also recommended you have seen our Tools Overview video before watching this. We'll explore Relinking Tool by way of example. When a link has its From Relinkable and or To Relinkable properties set to true, the Relinking Tool adds one or two adornments, a diamond at each relinkable end of the selected link. The user can drag a relinking handle to reconnect that end of the link to another port. The Relinking Tool automatically updates the relationships between nodes or ports, both in the diagram and the model. Let's demonstrate this. We'll start with a standard auto node template that treats its shape as its port. We'll make this explicit by setting the port ID property of the shape. Make sure the shape's from linkable and to linkable properties are set to true. When we construct our link template, be sure to set the relinkable from and relinkable to properties to true. We'll have four node data objects in our model, and one link data object. Load the page. When we select the link, we see the two relink handles on either end. Since the node's shape element has the from linkable and to linkable properties set to true, and the link has its from relinkable and to relinkable properties set to true, we can drag either of these handles to another node and see that the link now connects the other node. You can customize the relink handles by setting the relinking tool.fromHandle archetype and relinking tool.toHandle archetype. The value for this property is usually a small shape element. We'll set our myDiagram.toolManager.relinkingTool.fromHandle archetype to a diamond shape with a desired size of 9x9, a green stroke, and lime fill. We'll then set its segment index property, which gets or sets the segment index of a graph object that is in a link. We'll set it to 0, which represents the first segment of the link, the from end. We'll do the exact same thing for the toHandle archetype, except we'll change its stroke and fill colors to be red and pink, respectively, and set its segment index property to -1, which represents the last segment of the link, the to end. Now, if we load the page, we see that when we click a link, the relink handles appear as we set them to be, a small green diamond on the from end of the link and a small red diamond on the to end of the link. Both the linking and relinking tools support something called link validation, which is a function that acts as a predicate to determine whether or not a link between two ports would be valid. Let's add a link validation function to our linking tool now. The function accepts four parameters: the from node, the from port, the to node, and the to port. If this function is being set for the relinking tool, it accepts a fifth parameter as well, which is a reference to the link being considered for reconnection. Let's make our function really simple. We'll only allow relinking if the from node, the node the link is coming from, is the alpha node. If we reload our page, we see a relinking operation is only successful if the from node is the alpha node. Next, we'll look at the link reshaping tool. When a link has its reshapable property set to true, the link reshaping tool adds an adornment with several reshape handles at the interior points of a selected link's route. When the user drags a reshape handle, the route of the link is modified. Let's start with a simple auto node template and a link template that defines links as reshapable and orthogonally routed. We'll have two node data objects and one link data object in our model. Load the page. If we click the link, two reshape handles appear. If we drag these handles, our link is reshaped. We can customize these reshape handles by setting the link reshaping tool.handle archetype property, like we customized the relinking tool handles, but we will not do that in this video. Let's go back and set the resegmentable property in our link template to true. This allows users to add or remove segments from links. Let's reload the page and have a look for ourselves. If we click the link, we see the resegmenting handles now, which are even smaller blue diamonds at the middle of each link segment. When we drag a resegmenting handle, a new segment is inserted into the link's route. Since we're using orthogonal links, two new segments are introduced to maintain orthogonality. If we reshape the link so that adjacent segments are nearly collinear, the segment or segments are removed from the route. Some tools make use of special parts that they add to the tool layer as feedback during the tool's operation. We'll observe two such tools now, the drag selecting tool and the linking tool. The drag selecting tool lets the user select multiple parts within a rectangular area drawn by the user. The tool makes use of a temporary part, stored in its box property, that shows the current area encompassed by the mouse down point and the current mouse point. The default drag selection box is a magenta rectangle. See? You can change the box to customize its appearance. Let's do this now. Set mydiagram.toolmanager.dragselectingtool.box to a fresh part. Ensure it's in the tool layer by setting its layer name property to tool. Then add a shape element. We'll give this shape a cloud figure with no fill and a thick lime stroke. Reload the page and then try drag selecting. The box now appears as a lime cloud. Both the linking tool and relinking tool inherit from a base class called linking base tool that uses several temporary parts, a temporary link, and temporary to and from nodes. The default temporary link appears as a blue link with a standard arrowhead on one side. The originating port and the potential target port are shown by the linkingBaseTool.temporaryFrom node and linkingBaseTool.temporaryTo node. Their default values are magenta rectangles, enclosing the potential ports they represent. Let's alter the temporary link that is made by the linking tool. We'll set our linkingTool.temporaryLink to a fresh link, ensuring its layer is tool. Then, we'll modify its first and only shape, which represents the route of the link. We'll give it a wide red stroke and set its stroke-array property to an array holding 4, 2, which helps give the route a dashed appearance. Now, reload the page. If we go to link our two nodes together, we see the temporary link appears as a dashed red line. That's it for this video. To learn more, visit the intro page on tools. We recommend you watch Tools, Resizing, Rotating, and Adornments. Head over to gojs.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.